Under both the federal and the Liberal and the Conservative government in the last 10 years, the federal deficit has increased. So I find it a little bit hard to believe that, you know, when you ask them about this issue and they say that they care about it, that they're going to do something about it. You work both for the Liberal or the Conservative and you care about fiscal responsibility, you're probably just going to be deceived once again. The PPC is committed to reducing the deficit. We don't want to cut into the social programs, so there is things that we're going to do, such as defunding the CDC, stop spending money on a foreign nation that has, how do I say it, nothing to do with humanitarian stuff, and we intend to, like I said, cut taxes, grow the economy, and as the economy grows, we can have more revenues. I understand the temptation to tax rich people all the time for everything, but, you know, I mean, yes, we need to tax them, but at the same time, the world that we live in today is not the same as it was before. They can move to other places, in states like Illinois and New York and, you know, Maryland, most of them has already fled to other states because of lower taxes. We need to find a way to be able to generate income without always just relying on the rich. John F. Kennedy once said, and I know it's a little old-fashioned, but he once said that, you know, ask not what the nation can do for you, but what you can do for the nation. So we need some personal responsibility, and we need to grow the economy, and we need to get everybody actively involved in generating revenues. Thank you.
Thank you, Jeremy. Thank you to the candidates, and thank you for your questions. That ends the Q&A section of this meeting. We'll now ask the candidates for their closing remarks. Each will have 3 minutes. We'll start with candidate 3, Hal.